Hello students, welcome to online classes of Semstar Global School. I'm Fizza Akhtar and we were doing this poem, The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. I gave the summary yesterday. Those who are joining for the first time, please see that video and then come here. We'll do line by line explanation of the first two stanzas of this poetry today. But before that, let's read the whole poem once and then we'll proceed. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry, I could not travel both. And be one traveler, long I stood and looked down as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other as just as fair and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as for that, the passing there had worn them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay, in leaves no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less travelled by, and that has made all the difference. Okay, so I'm starting with the first stanza. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. Now this speaker, he is travelling in a wood. Wood is a forest. And he came to a point where two roads, they diverged into different directions. Diverged means they separated and they went into two different directions. That means he is standing at the split of a road. And the woods are yellow, probably because it is the time of a fall, means your autumn season, and that is why the leaves are changing colors. So the speaker is standing at the fork in a road and he's saying, and sorry, I could not travel both, and be one traveler, long I stood. The speaker wants to go down on both the roads, means he do not want to choose any one of it. But because it was impossible to travel on both the roads, that is why he's saying sorry. That sorry, I could not travel both. And he is regretting his decision. And because of the impossibility of traveling both the roads together, he's saying that, and be one traveler, long I stood. That means he's standing there and he's trying to choose which way he has to go. This shows that he's standing on foot, not sitting in any carriage or car, but he's on his foot. And looked down as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. The speaker really wants to go on both the roads. That is why he's trying to figure out and he's trying to choose which path he should take. And that is why he's looking down as far as he can. But the undergrowth, that is the bushes and the plants and the greenery, that is blocking his way. Because he could only see to a point where the road bends, and it bent in the undergrowth. Means he could see, after that bend, he could only see the bushes and the greenery. Nothing else he could see after that. So that was all about the first stanza. I hope this much is clear to everybody. Let's move towards the second. Then took the other as just as fair and having perhaps the better claim. Now the speaker decides and he finally chooses a path which he thinks and he believes is better for him. And having perhaps the better claim. The better claim means here what he believes and what he thinks is more appealing or more attractive to him. So he chooses a path that was less traveled by other people because it was grassy and wanted wear. And that is why he chooses a path which seems to him that it hasn't been walked upon much. Means it wanted wear. It was less traveled by the people. So he chose that path because that seems more appealing to him. Then he says, though as for that, the passing there had won them really about the same. And now he immediately changes his mind because he was unable to come to a conclusion whether he had chosen the path that was good for him or not. So he says, though as for that refers to the other path that he has left behind. So he says, the other path that he had left behind, it was worn out by the people who had traveled on it by foot. So he was unable to decide for himself that the path he has chosen, the path that was less traveled by the people, is better for him, or the path that he has left behind would have been better for him. So he is in a confused state of mind. We can compare this situation with our real life also. That suppose in our career, there comes a point, there comes a time where you have to choose between two choices or between two streams. Suppose, I'll go with a very simple example. Suppose you reach class 12th and you wanted to take bio also and you wanted to take maths also. But you decided to take and you decided to go for bio. And after opting for biology, you are in a state of confusion that whether this decision is correct or not. Whether I should have taken biology or I should have opted for maths. So you're not able to decide between the two situations. This is the same thing that is happening with the speaker also. He is unable to decide whether he has taken a good decision or a bad one. So we'll see this and we'll complete the poetry in the next part of the video. Till then, you have to keep revising, keep studying, everybody. Take care of yourself and your family. Thank you.